Hello and welcome back. Today I'm gonna make an infinite terrain in Blender where you have some dynamic subdivisions to get a feasible infinite terrain. So let's get started. As terrain we're gonna use a plane and subdivide it a lot. So the idea here is to subdivide it further in the middle and then repeat the process. So you get some nice terrain around your camera and some lower details in the distance. Now we need a geometry node to make our procedural terrain. So we start with a set position node, and by combining the Z component with some noise, for example, we get a very simple terrain. You can maybe scale it to see it a little bit better, and this could be our terrain. So now we can actually see from the top view how the terrain is working in the end. So we have the like perfectly detailed terrain here in the middle around the camera and lower details at the edges. But it isn't moving. Like, you can move it, but the terrain, of course, stays with the mesh. So we have to do something against that. So we need a empty or something that marks the origin of your world. And then we get a object info node and guess the empty object. And with that, we can now offset the position of the plane here with a vector math node. And we also have to set the object info to relative and this to subtract. And now, if I show it here, if we move now our terrain, we can see that the noise, our mountains and valleys, stay in their position. They don't move. Go here into the right side panel, and we're gonna add a driver with right click to the location of our terrain. And there we're selecting the camera and repeat the same process for the Y axis. So now we're gonna select the Y location. And now the camera determines our terrain position. Let me make it a little bit so we can see some of the terrain. So I think there's a problem. You can see how we see the mesh like moving, and like I don't know if that's even like a feasible way to make infinite terrain. But my workaround for this, because I don't find this quite pleasing, what's happening here, is to go again, right click, edit drivers, show in drivers editor, and here for both axes, we're gonna go to modifiers and add a stepped interpolation, and we can change the value here, the important value, later. Okay, so now what's the difference? Let's see. You can see in the distance there's a little bit of updating going on, but because of the set interpolation step, there's not that much movement in the foreground because it's going in a strict way every few steps. You can change this step, of course, but I think it's working quite nicely. And Yeah, we can scroll, like, I don't know. We could go to, I don't know, 5,000, 5,000, and we still have terrain. So it doesn't matter, really. And, like, this, of course, is a very simple example. You could have some crazy noises, combine them together, and get some quite nice looking terrain. And maybe for the thumbnail, I'm gonna add a plane and also parent it to the camera. Maybe let's reset the position of the camera so we can see it as a little water thing, so we have a little bit more of nice interactions. And this, the thing is, you also don't need to make this that big, because you again can just parent it to the camera. And now, yeah, we have some water. And yeah, it's working quite nicely. So now I'm gonna add some shaders to showcase the final result. But I think that's not the point of this thing, what I wanted to show you. So if you want to see that, comment. Yeah, and maybe you can do some nice things with this technique. Bye.